Hi, so my name is Aryan Danani, and I'm going to be presenting on personal and interpersonal learning with Quizlet Live. So, just a bit about me. I'm going into the eighth grade at Green Hill School, which is in Addison, Texas, and I've been using Quizlet ever since I went into the middle school, and I conduct and support most of the Quizlet activity at Green Hill. Okay, so as I was saying, this is our agenda for today. We're going to go over how to set up Quizlet Live, and then we're going to go through more things such as choosing the right study set, and then showing you guys examples of games of Quizlet Live. And so first, how to set up Quizlet Live. So I have a few screenshots to show you guys. So now when you go on a set, you're going to see something that goes along the lines of this. So just you have to make sure that you are on a teacher account to be able to access the Quizlet Live feature. But you are going to see a little button that says live, and you're going to go ahead and press that. And so next, once you go to this screen, you're going to create the game and make sure that you are on the correct set. And so the top left image is what the teacher is going to see, and the bottom right image is what the students are going to see. So the students are going to have to go to Quizlet.live, and from there they can enter the same code, and once they press join game, the teacher will be able to see the list of the students. So first, let's talk about choosing the right set. So I have two examples for you. And the first one is like what sets might not work in it. So right here, this set wouldn't really work for a few reasons. So the main two are that there aren't 12 terms in the set, so you wouldn't be able to do live with that. And another reason is because you have duplicate terms. It may still have different answers, but it could be confusing for the students when they click the answer for the term, and it might say it's wrong even though it's correct. And another one is true and false questions, because if something comes up like this and the student says true, there's still a possibility that as it gives it wrong because it's talking about a different one that's true. So then let's talk about one that does work. Well, specific answers really work great. And I think that sentences also work really well also, because then the students have to read through the sentence and try to match up the one that's correct. So I have this example up here that shows you all that sets that are more specific will be able to work a lot better. So let's move on. So now let's play a game of Quizlet Live. So right now, if you'd like to participate, please go to Quizlet.live. And we are going to go ahead and go to this hyperlink I had right here. There we go. So we're going to be doing U.S. state capitals as our sample set, and we're going to play a game of Live. So if you'd like to play this game of Quizlet Live, go to Quizlet.live, and here's the join code which you're going to type in.
Hey, Aryan, we're going to play too.
All right.
Any chance we can play Quizlet Live at the Quizlet office, we definitely take. Okay. And this, of course, demoing live is a little different from playing in your classroom, because in your classroom, students will be able to talk to each other and communicate. But obviously here, you'll just be hearing Laura, Mai, and Ruvij's voices while we play. But we'll try to keep the game going, keep the excitement up.
So we're gonna wait another few minutes.
Wow, 84 students. This is a big game. Hopefully people know their state capitals. Yeah, and as you can see on the right, students' names are popping up, and if for, you know, some strange reason a student entered a bad username or something that you didn't think was quite appropriate, you can easily just exit out by hovering, like Aryan is, and then clicking on it. And that will just remove the name and allow that student to rejoin the game with an appropriate name.
And one other tip, if you're playing this with your class, and maybe you have 30 kids in your class, there's a good chance that a couple students have the same name. You can always encourage them to do first name, last initial, to help make it clear who's who.
Okay, how many do we have now?
We have 111.
Woo! Okay, yeah. That's probably enough. So everyone, quickly, 10-second countdown, get in the game. We might play again at a later time if you're not in this one. So I think we're ready to go. Click the button. Yay!
So we're going to hit sign.
All right, so you want to explain a little bit about random teams?
Okay, so you can customize teams, but that is a Quizlet premium Quizlet Pro function. So if you have the Quizlet Pro, then you can customize teams, but you can do randomized teams even with the normal Quizlet. And so if for any reason somebody accidentally is not in it and you miss them, you can always go back and add more students. And you can also shuffle teams like this if you want to change up. So I think we're going to start the game now.
Great, go for it.
And so this is how the teacher page looks. Obviously, it won't have this many teams if you're in a classroom environment, because right now there are a lot of people playing. But in the classroom environment, usually there are 4 to 5 and sometimes even 6 teams. And so it'll assign a random name to it, which I believe is usually animals, which is pretty fun.
Right, and so if you're part of the game right now, what you should be seeing on your screen is 4 different columns with a different name over it. And essentially, we're all seeing the question, but only one of us has the answer. So right now, I'm on Team Ostriches.
The Dolphins team is killing it.
Now the Dolphins team is about to win.
Well, they got it. They didn't need the explanation.
Here we go. One more.
Oh, that was so fast.
Congratulations to Caroline, Sharon, JLD, and Kathy. You Woo-hoo. Guys killed it.
Maybe they played Quizlet Lab before. Maybe they studied
this. Rematch.
Rematch. Let's play again. Okay.
Ooh, I'm on here.
We're on the same team. I think this is a really intense advantage. But we'll still play. Okay.
So if you guys saw right before I pressed start game, it had said that some student had disconnected. That happens sometimes. And so that's a good tool so that you know if somebody's computer has disconnected from Quizlet Live. So we have a few teams at 4 and a few at 5 right now. And it looks like Dolphins, again, are in the lead.
Dolphins just the winning animal today. I feel like our team, the Alpacas, is doing pretty well.
I think so, too.
Cheyenne? Who is Cheyenne?
Wyoming.
Why? Okay, well, we shouldn't cheat.
Dolphins won again.
Oh. Dolphins! It's incredible.
Yeah.
All right, do we want to play one more time? Or are we done?
We don't.
I just really want to win. All right, one more time, everyone.
Sea dragons.
So a few teams have gotten up to 1. Here we go, and pretty exciting. A bunch of teams are neck and neck. T-Rex exes are in the lead right now. We're dolphins. Your exes, oh, they just lost the, they got one of the questions wrong. So as you can see, if you get one of the questions wrong, it resets it and you have to start all over. Looks like bald eagles are in the lead.
Yeah, bald eagles are in the lead.
What's great about that is that students don't just race to, like, choose any answer. They really have to be conscious of which answer they're choosing because they know that they have to go all the way back to the start.
Oh, hey.
Yes.
Is that the bison?
Oh, the bison one.
What team is that? Is that a bison? Great job. Pilar, JB, St. J, Lauren K, and Amy Miller. Great job. Okay, let's get back to the presentation, but... That was great. Thanks for demoing that, Aryan. It's a really fun game, and it's really easy to pick up, as you guys can tell.
Extremely fun. Okay, so now we're going to move on to why students love it. I'm a student myself, and once the day Quiz Alive came out, it was basically an entire change to the classroom environment. Students started really looking forward to playing Quiz Alive, and we all really enjoyed the class when we do. So, I mean, competition is obviously something that's everywhere. And so students love having that competition. And it's extremely fun to be able to compete against your friends and still be learning at the same time. So also, students really, really like being able to work with their friends and their classmates as a team. And so Quiz Alive adds that to it. And so students really enjoy it in that sense as well. Now, I'll come back to this point in a bit more depth, but it's online, and students really, really love technology. And in today's world, students want to do as much as they can online. So also, this is something you can do. Obviously, it's optional, but if you give out prizes, students love receiving those prizes. So let's move on to the end of why teachers love it. Teachers really love it because the students are still learning and it's really less hassle for the teacher to prepare a game. So teachers also get to see how the students are progressing in a topic overall. And students, so teachers love it when they hear students talking about how much fun their class is and how much they enjoy it. And so teachers really like that when students are like, oh my god, this class is so awesome, so much fun. And so I'm going to quote my Spanish teacher, Miss Lowenstein, who wasn't able to be here today with us. She said, "Ed, in the old version of teaching on pencil and paper, it just doesn't work anymore. Like, to reinforce it, now, but Quizlet Live adds a huge reinforcement aspect to make it be able to really the students get it into their heads, the term and the answer. And so it's also fun to learn the skills without the teacher. Think about if you were a student and you had to rely on the teacher for everything. Now, Quizlet Live, it's something that it's their achievement for learning about. The teachers, of course, helping out a lot with it, but still the students have that sense of, like, victory and pride. So let's go ahead and move on to the next slide. So here are a few tips on using Quizlet Live. So you want to specify how you want the students to play Quizlet Live. So do you want the students to do it in silent round, like no talking or talking? Because silent round adds a different sense to the game. So I'm going to really quickly share an experience that I had before. So we had actually done a Quizlet Live tournament at the end of the year before finals so that we can just get a sense of all the things we had learned through the year. So this was in Spanish, and so the students really enjoyed a Quizlet Live tournament. Now the one thing about Quizlet Live tournaments that may be a bit of a drawback is that it takes a lot of preparation to do it. That's the one drawback of it. But we also once tried Quizlet Live happening in different classrooms in the where we had two Spanish classes going on at once, and so it's a bit fun to see how the students interact with people outside of their class, and they have to work together even though they're not in the same area. Okay, that was weird. But also teachers, the students love it when teachers get into the game. Like, students really enjoy when the teachers are announcing who's winning, and when somebody misses a question, the teachers can announce that one team's getting ahead and stuff like that. So the students also get to see where their competition is going ahead. And so one thing that's super important that all teachers should make sure of is that the student is only touching their own device. Many times students will touch their teammate's device if they know the answer. That's not how it should be, because all the students should be able to have their own learning experience. Even if that means getting one wrong, they should still have that experience. And so another fun version of Quizlet Live that we've done is Quizlet 11. It's really where you go to 11, you get 11 right, and then you just wait. Once you've gotten those 11 right, and everybody gets it right, that way you can see which teams are struggling more, and then the students can race to click the last button to see who's going to win. So that's really enjoyable, and we've done that as well in our classroom. But I know that we enjoy that a lot. So Quizlet Live is changing the entire classroom environment. As I said, the first day that we did Quizlet Live, I walked into class. I wasn't really using Quizlet as much as I use it now. Like, this past year, I was using it every day. I was using it for so many hours. But at that time, I used Quizlet less, and I didn't really know that Quizlet Live was coming out. So what had happened is I walked into class, and my teacher was like, "Class, take out your computers and go to Quizlet.live. We're going to play a game." And I was like, this is strange, because I had used Quizlet, and I didn't know that there was a game that we could use as teams. So my teacher queued up Quizlet Live, and we all played the game. And just that first experience that I had playing Quizlet Live was something that it's extremely so much fun, and you feel like you have a sense of achievement. So what happens many times is students do not get enough sleep at night. They're doing so much homework that they don't get enough rest and stuff like that. So when the students enter the class, they might not even be paying attention. But when they play Quizlet Live, the class is suddenly awake and they're in a good mood, and they're cheering themselves on and cheering their friends and other teams on as well. And so the class not only is having fun, they're actually reminded of the content that was reviewed. And the class is warmed up for the day and ready to learn. And so then the class is, once the class is warmed up, attentive, and ready to go, the class is taking better notes, and the students pay attention because they're in a good mood and enjoyed themselves at the beginning. Now, once the class leaves, if they leave with like a thirst for learning, because now they're ready to go, they're wide awake for the rest of the day. And even if you're at the end of the day, students are really tired from the long day at school. So Quizlet Live is also a nice way to make them more relaxed, even though the competition sets. So if it's at the beginning of the day, the class will be more attentive in other subjects as well. Let me give you an example of when myself, this happened to me. So, we have a lot of tests at Green Hill and quizzes. So, I mean, usually I'm tired when I come into the day, and Spanish is my first subject of the day. So, when my teacher would let us play a Quizlet Live game at the beginning, I would feel like a sense of getting warmed up, and I'm ready to go. I'm wide awake because of the sudden competition I had, and I played and enjoyed it as well. And so I'm ready to go for the rest of the day, and I take great notes and all of that. So let's continue on. So friendship is a big part of Quizlet Live. So students social interact a lot in Quizlet Live, and I personally have made many friends playing Quizlet Live. So when a student plays Quizlet Live and they find a team that works really well together, they start talking to the person that they work well together, and soon enough they do become friends. So that's a very common thing that happens in between students, and so they really, really do enjoy that. And so teamwork is also a huge part of Quizlet Live, as I sort of went on before. Teamwork is the key to winning and learning in Quizlet Live. So as I said before, the students should allow everybody to have a chance to do their own thing. Now the students cheer each other on to get the questions right. And even during the Quizlet Live tournament, when some students weren't in on the game itself, they're still cheering on their classmates and watching their screens so that they can get a review of the knowledge as well. So when students social interact, it's only natural that they make friends with the people that they do well with. So this is a huge part of Quizlet Live right here. Academic value of Quizlet Live. Quizlet Live has a huge academic value. And so I do have a story about our finals. That we did a Quizlet Live tournament, as I said before, right before finals. Now, before finals, everybody is super stressed out. Teachers are trying to go over as much as material as possible. And so the students are really nervous. And sometimes being very nervous also leads to not doing well on the finals. So what a few of my teachers, such as history, Spanish, and English, decided to do is that we were going to play Quizlet Live at the beginning and the end of the class to sort of ease out that tension. So at the beginning of class, we were super nervous because finals were coming up. And so we would go to class, and our teacher would be like, take out your computers, we're going to play a game of Quizlet Live. So we all are happy because we get a break from the lectures and all of that, and the reviewing, the normal kind of old school reviewing that used to happen before technology and Quizlet came around. So when the students play that Quizlet Live, they don't learn just by themselves, they actually learn from each other and from their mistakes. And the students are able to learn the content in a more comfortable and fun environment. So that really means that the students are enjoying themselves, and instead of having to like sit super attentive, afraid of missing any word during a lecture, they're able to easily play Quizlet Live and learn the content even better than a lecture would get them. Now, we talked about this a bit when we were playing the game of Quizlet Live, but students can't just guess. If they do, then they have to start all over. That stays in their mind, and so they do their best to make sure that they know everything. And whereas in different activities, sometimes students are able to guess and get the answer right, but Quizlet Live isn't like that. And so even when the student makes a mistake, they keep that mistake that they made in their mind and to allow them to get it right the next time. So Quizlet Live helps the students learn the content actually better than a normal lecture, because the students' minds are constantly working to learn and remember the answers so that they could win the game. But now what a lot of people do not realize is that when their students' minds are working constantly just to win the game, it actually puts in their minds, which are going to help them do well on tests and learn the content. So students, another thing that I've noticed a lot in my classmates and myself is students sometimes do not like to study. Now personally, I love to study, I enjoy school a lot, but a lot of students don't like to study, they find it very boring and not fun at all. But see, what happens know that they're going to play a game of Quiz It Live, they go home and they want to study so that they can know the material and content. When they do study, they really work hard in knowing the material, and meaning that they're going to do well in the class, and ultimately the main goal of school is to teach them valuable lessons and topics, which is going to happen automatically. And so, it's a win-win situation for the teacher and the student, because the students want to have that winning sense of feeling and enjoy themselves, while the teachers want the students to learn the content and also enjoy the class. Now, teachers have to go through a huge hassle of coming up with lesson plans, executing the lesson plans, making sure that it'll be enjoyable or the students will pay attention. And so with Quizlet Live, all the teacher really has to do is enter the terms into the set itself, which even sometimes teachers designate a student to do. Like myself, I do most of the Quizlet set making in my classes. So the teachers are able to play that game of Quizlet Live, and the students enjoy that more than any really handmade game. And the students really feel like the teacher is making sure that their class is enjoyable. And so the other way of a win-win situation is that the teachers really like to see their students win. And the teachers get to see where their class is at. So if the class is taking a long time to finish the one game of Quizlet Live, the teacher knows that they're going to have to put in more effort into teaching this certain topic because it may be a bit harder. So now we're going to move on to the Q&A section. So does anybody have any questions?
Great. That was an awesome presentation. Thank you so much. And we have a lot of really good questions coming in. Before we move on to Q&A, there's a little bit of confusion around how exactly to play Quizlet Live. So let's review it just one more time. Basically, Quizlet Live is a collaborative in-class team game. And what it does is your students will join the game after a teacher has started it. And we will divide and randomize your students into teams. And in a normal classroom setting, in a standard game, students would get up once they see what team they're on, which is, you know, signified by the animal name that appears on their screen. They would get up and then go to a table with their teammates. And then once a teacher starts the game, what a student will see on their screen is a prompt, which is usually like the term. In this case, it was the state capital. And we were required to choose which state that corresponded with. So each student has like a slightly different screen. They see the prompt, but then they each have a different selection of answers that they can choose from. But no student on the same team will have the same answer. So they actually have to work together to figure out which student has the right answer. And that person is in charge of selecting that answer for the benefit of the team. So hopefully that is a little bit more clarified and explains what you were seeing if you joined that game of Quizlet Live that we demoed. And I also added in the chat box or in the questions box on your webinar tools a link to another demo of Quizlet Live that you can watch and keep that explanation in mind. Okay, so other questions?
First, I wanted to say that we're getting a bunch of, they're not really questions as much as they are just great job comments for Arian. So thank you so much for taking time out of your, I don't know if you're back in school or your summer break, to come and talk to us and share your story with us. But it looks like teachers found a lot of great stuff in your presentation. So thank you so much for taking that time. We really appreciate it.
Okay. So a couple of questions. From Caroline, can students use Quizlet Live on mobile phones? Our school doesn't have a lot of free iPads or computers for use in the classroom. And the answer to that is yes. Arian, do you want to explain that a little bit more?
Yeah, definitely. Quizlet Live, it works on many devices, and that includes iPads, tablets, and mobile phones and computers. And so students are definitely able to use their mobile phone to do it. So Quizlet visit live, and so that sometimes is easier for the students, and they feel more comfortable playing on their own.
Awesome. I see this is not a question from Teresa, but just a fun tip. I think this was put into the question box while we were talking about encouraging your students to put in their names, maybe with their last initial. Teresa says, I sometimes tell the kids to sign in as your hero, sign in as your favorite sports player, sign with your middle name, your mom's name, your dad's name. She says the kids like it, and it's just another thinking piece. And that's a great customization, too. So I can imagine if you are teaching history, for example, you're teaching American history, you could say sign in as your favorite Revolutionary War hero. Or if you're teaching Spanish, you could say sign in as your favorite Spanish verb. There's a bunch of different ways to customize.
Get creative.
Yeah, get creative. Obviously, names are a super easy way to get your students organized, but there's tons of ways to customize that as well.
Yeah, and here's another mention. Not so
and
much.
We did something in like that in English when we had a set about questions and answers for a book, To Kill a Mockingbird. So we were all choosing a name of a character in To Kill a Mockingbird.
That's awesome. That's great. Good example. So yeah, not another question, but just another mention from Deb. She says, if you teach a language, you can get the animal names in that language. And so that's a great thing to point out. We might have mentioned it before, but the animal names that you saw on your screen, we actually translate those if you are teaching Spanish, if you're teaching French, if you're teaching German, a bunch of other languages. So that's just kind of a fun thing to see and have your students kind of, get excited about.
Camilla asks, is this something we can use in the computer lab, or do the students need to provide their own devices? What's the difference between Quizlet and Quizlet Live? So I'll answer the first part of that question first, and then we'll go to the second part. So you can, if you are in like a one-to-one school and students have Chromebooks or iPads or tablets, or you're a BYOD school, it's really easy to play Quizlet Live in your classroom. Your students can get up and move around and get placed into their teams. But we've also seen people play Quizlet Live in a computer lab as well. And essentially what happens is students will get up and move around. It works best if you have the the Quizlet teacher upgrade, so that you can make your teams custom to how you want, to how your students are sitting. But then your students can be grouped that way, or you can have students essentially play without moving around. So we'll see, similar to sort of how we played remotely over this unconference, where not everybody could see what everyone else was doing on their team. If you have students scattered around a computer lab, they'll see three options on their screen. They'll miss out on some of the collaborative parts of Quizlet Live, but they can still play the game.
Yeah, and that's actually interesting. We've heard from teachers and students that sometimes they prefer to play that way. One, because it actually makes the game harder, right? You can't really rely on your teammates to help you out. You really do have to have an understanding of the material on your own. Another reason is that sometimes students like that it's not always clear who got the answer wrong for their team and caused them to go all the way back to the start. So I've heard from students sometimes that they actually prefer to play, not together with their teams, so that they have less of that kind of pressure. So there's a lot of different ways to play, and it really is up to, experimenting with all of them and seeing what works best for you.
The second part of Camilla's question was, what's the difference between Quizlet and Quizlet Live? So Quizlet is our company. And we offer 7 different learning modes, or study modes. Quizlet Live is one of those. But we also offer a bunch of individualized study modes for students. So that includes flashcards, test, learn, spell, match, and gravity. And those are all different study modes that students can play on their own. They can play them, or they can use them at home as part of, homework, or just working on building foundational learning, or you can use Quizlet study modes in the classroom. But Quizlet Live is our collaborative and competitive game. So that's Quizlet Live is one of the things you can do on Quizlet, but it's certainly not the only thing.
Right, that's great. Quizlet is the platform with a bunch of different offerings, and Quizlet Live is one of those offerings. So I see a few questions around Quizlet Live 11, which Arian mentioned briefly. And I just wanted to talk about that a little bit more. That's an idea that we heard from one of our teacher ambassadors, and it's actually posted as a story on our blog, which I'll make sure to share in the question box for all of you to peruse. But essentially, essentially, that is a way to get absolutely every student engaged in the game. And what you will do is actually have teams go all the way to answering 11 questions, but not answer the 12th. So they will stop there, which means the gameplay will continue to go until every team is at 11. So that means that maybe, you know, Team Dolphins is really fast and gets to 11 really fast, but it gives Team Ostriches time to actually answer all of the questions up to 11. So just another great adaptation as an idea from our teacher community.
Vicky asks, what is an ideal size for each group in Quizlet Live? And our game will actually, once you enter the game, it will automatically sort students into groups of 3 or 4. So there isn't a way to customize that. That will happen automatically. Though I'll go ahead and answer a question we also sometimes get, which is what happens if you have fewer than 6 students, or you know you don't want the you want students to be competing individually. And what we've seen students do for that, or teachers do for that, is this works much better in classrooms that have one-to-one devices as opposed to a computer lab. But you'll essentially set up 3 screens in front of an individual student. So they'll have the question, and then they'll have 3 different screens that have all the available answers on it, and they can compete that way. But as a teacher, you don't need to worry about how many students are in each Quizlet Live group, because our game will automatically sort them.
I see a couple of questions around getting access to Quizlet Live and asking if it's an upgraded feature. And it's actually not. So if you have a free account on Quizlet, and when you signed up, you said you were a teacher, you will have access to play Quizlet Live. And how you get access to it is just to go to any set page and look for the Quizlet Live button. Press that button, and you will start a game. And like Aryan said, if the set has less than a certain number of terms, you'll see that button grayed out. So if it's grayed out, that's probably the reason why.
And just to add on that, if you accidentally didn't put the teacher account when you started it, you can actually go into settings and fix that under your profile.
Great, yeah. So go to your settings, and in your settings, there's an option to change your account to a teacher account.
Julie says, and this is, directed at Aryan, but I can answer it. She says, Aryan, you sound very responsible, but assuming that not all of our students are, do you as an 8th grader have suggestions on how to get students to put in names that are appropriate? So Aryan, do you have any thoughts on that? I can also answer sort of what teachers can do if something does happen.
Yeah, so a lot of students don't decide to put something appropriate in, which definitely you should make that super clear that that's not okay. Like, as we said before, you could do something like if you told the students to put something from a character from a book or something like that. But you definitely want to be extremely stern on putting the right kind of name in.
Yeah, and then, because we know that most students are great, but some students like to mess around, and sometimes we'll see people put in names. We've seen people put in names, of other students or make jokes. As the teacher, you have the option to strike through a name and remove it from the game. So that's always an option available to you. I think setting the ground rules, as Aryan said, is probably the best way to do it at the beginning.
And one more thing. We actually use emojis, and if you tell your students that they can add appropriate emojis, students sometimes are more compelled to put something appropriate with a nice emoji.
That is a great tip. I love that.
Here's a great question from Ying. Ying says, do students need to set up their own Quizlet accounts in order to play Quizlet Live? And they don't. So all they need to have is access to a web browser. And if they type in quizlet.live, they'll see the option to put in the code. And so we see a lot of teachers who have students under the age of 13, where there's some extra sort of layers of security and privacy around setting up on Quizlet, play Quizlet Live with their students just as well as teachers with older students do. And I'll also note that actually works across Quizlet. So you don't need an account to use any of our individual study modes. Obviously, as a teacher, you do need an account to set up the Quizlet Live game, but your students don't need to register to use Quizlet or to play Quizlet Live, though there are some pretty great benefits to registering, including being able to track what you've learned, create your own sets, star different terms to know to focus on those, track progress over time, etc.
Be organized into classes, yeah. We definitely encourage it, but for some teachers who are just kind of using Quizlet Live or using Quizlet Live with younger students, it's totally easy to just get them in the game without having to create accounts. So I see a question from Kelsey. She says, Ariane, what a wonderful job as a teacher. What kind of rewards would you suggest? And I'm assuming that means rewards for winners of Quizlet Live.
Yeah, so I definitely suggest not something too large, obviously, but something smaller. Like, sometimes if you're doing a tournament, you can get, like, a mini trophy. Like, they have these tiny trophies that you can give out to the winning team. And also, you could give them candy. That's always an option that we use at Green Hill. And it's just something for the students to look forward to and to try their best.
And one other idea, and Mr. Sneed may have mentioned this in his past presentation, or he might be mentioning it coming up, but his prize for the winning teams in Quizlet Live is a paw print, like a paper paw print cutout. I think their school motto is like the bears or the tigers or the cats or something that has a paw. And they just get to write their names on it and then paste it up on a wall. And it's pretty incredible that even after playing Quizlet Live, you know, dozens and dozens of times and seeing so many paw prints on the wall, the students are still so excited to get to write their name on a little paw print and paste it up there. So I think the prizes can often be a little more psychological than even physical, just to reward the work and give some recognition.
Keep going. What?
No, I just said yeah.
Okay. Yeah, definitely. Okay, awesome. So I see a few questions around wondering what you get with the free version of Quizlet versus the paid teacher subscription version of Quizlet. And in the Quizlet Live setting, the main differences are with a free account, you can play Quizlet Live. You can play it on any set with the right number of terms and with the right amount of students. And you will have like access to the automatic shuffling of teams and all of the core features of Quizlet Live. But with an upgraded Quizlet teacher account, you can actually, customize teams. So let's say, you know, Billy should not be on the same team as Bobby. You can actually separate them and customize those teams. You can also keep the gameplay going continuously. So right now with a free account, you start a game, you stop a game, you have to restart it. With the upgraded version, you're able to just kind of press one button to play the game again with the same teams, etc. So it makes it a little bit more efficient and speedy. And then the last one is that you can actually enable audio. So we were playing the game, silently in the sense of, you know, being able to hear the audio as I'm looking at terms and definitions. But as we know, that can be a really helpful kind of hint to what the answer might be. So with the upgraded version of Quizlet Live, you can actually, or the Quizlet teacher account, you can actually enable that audio as an added, you know, benefit to your students.
I see a couple of questions, again, about names in the classroom. So Kathy says they put in a pseudonym. How do they find each other? So students put in a pseudonym. They'll get slotted into a team. So we have ostriches and dolphins and sea dragons. And so you'll basically, there'll be a few minutes of cacophony in the classroom where people are like, sea dragons, where are the other sea dragons? So you can, students can find each other by associating each other with the names of their teams. And then Jacqueline has a great suggestion in regards to the question about like what to do about students who put in joke names or inappropriate names. She says, I hide the projector screen until I start the game so I have time to strike inappropriate ones. That has solved all problems, and that's a great suggestion, and that's why we love working with our teacher community, because that's something that I don't think we've heard before, but it certainly
definitely makes
it sense. It takes the fun, I think, out of a student putting in an inappropriate name if they can't get the reaction from the class. So.
Definitely. Good tip.
Yeah, that's a really good tip.
Okay, so I think we are out of time for Q&A, but thank you for all of the wonderful questions. And great job, Aryan. That was a wonderful presentation. We see so many positive comments about that. So thanks once again.
Okay, thank you so much.